Hi everybody, welcome back. So we're working with this cute set, Freezin Fun, Stampin' Up Holiday Catalog 2020. It's August 2020. And the funny thing about my project is I grabbed this stamp set to do this card today and I didn't even realize there were dies with it. And I have them. I just didn't grab them. So it might have changed the project completely. However, today we're gonna be doing Slimline cards, which are popular again. And it's funny, I went back through old Stamping School videos. There was one way back in 2007. There was just called Tall Skinny Cards back then. I don't know who named them Slimline. And then I had another one in 2011. So they've been around a long time. Sometimes they get a bad rap because they don't fit into a standard card envelope. But you know, if you have one of those business envelopes, like one of these, that you have for paying bills and stuff, that's what these fit. The card is 4 by 9 1/4, and that fits right inside one of these. I know you guys want to know how to make your own envelope for it, so I'll show you that at the end of the video. But they do take a whole piece of cardstock, really, by the time you get down to it, because it's, you know, 8 inches by 9 1/4, but it's kind of fun. And if I'd had the dies, I might have changed the layout and done some different things, but I kind of like it. And there's some good techniques in here. We're gonna do a few blending techniques and we're gonna do some masking and show how to get the circles in there just right with a punch and no dies. So the set is called Freezin Fun and lots of cute little guys in here and cute greetings. So to do this card, we have the new balmy blue glitter paper, which is really pretty. 3/4 inch, 2 pieces, one for the inside. This one is only 9 inches, that's for the front. The 9 1/4 goes on the inside of the card. And then you're gonna need another panel of white. So we're gonna, and this is where we're gonna do our punching. So this panel is 3 inches by 9 inches. And the Whisper White panel is 3 3/4 by 9 inches. So that we've got this right here and we're gonna be doing the punching here. That's so that the punch can reach up and down and we can get to it. If you wanted to use dies, you certainly could. You could run it through 4 times. You could run your circle dies through. You could also die cut the blue as a card and have these guys on the inside when you open it. So, and if you really don't want to do all this window stuff, you can just stamp these and punch them out and glue them on top of the card. So there's that. But I do think there's some fun interest with having them underneath the window like that. You go the extra mile. So we're using a 2-inch circle punch. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to position these guys and we're gonna draw just a little registration mark so we can punch them. And it, you up, down, whatever you wanna do, as long as it's fun and not, you can go perfectly straight, but then you've gotta do some more registration marks to make sure that they're perfectly straight all the way across. This way, you don't have to worry about it. And the other thing you can do is you can just wing it and punch it. However, you might not get them spaced and it might be kind of hard to tell. You might run out of room. So grab a little pencil and you really only have to do the tops and use a regular pencil, not a watercolor pencil, which I did the first time and it was harder to erase. So let's not do that. So there's my little registrations. 2-inch circle punch, and this is cut to 3 inches so that we can get to each side. We'll save those for another project. So I'm kind of going back and forth, one side to the other side. This would be really cute for birthdays. You can put all kinds of little images in here. It doesn't have to be cutesy, but how fun would this be for like a first or second grade birthday? And you can put cute little things in there. Obviously, slimline cards are popular because they're a little different and they allow you so much more room. So you've got more room for images on them because it's longer and bigger. All right, next stop. Now we're going to put this right up to the top here. And I need to make my little windows, my little registration marks so I can stamp in here. Because these guys are slightly bigger than the circle. And we need to just do a little bit of coloring with the blends. And that was one of the reasons why, because it will soak through on the other side, if you just did this right on your white card, then you're gonna have to cover this up in here, right? Because you're gonna see it. So we're gonna do an extra panel here and lightly draw your registration marks. And we'll erase those after. And now we can do some stamping. I'm using basic gray, the new basic gray, the one that is not waterproof, so that I can color with my blends, my alcohol markers. And I'm okay with that, with missing those little skis. If you wanted to, you could cut them out and put them here, but I don't think it needs it. It's not a big deal. The walrus, we're gonna have to do a little bit of masking on because he needs to sit on his ice. So we need to stamp him one more time on a piece of copy paper or a post-it. And we just need to cut out around his belly just a little. That's really all we need to do. Cover him up and then stamp just a touch over top of his belly there so it looks like he's sitting on the ice. Isn't that cute? This guy is supposed to be snowboarding, but we're just gonna have him look like he's jumping right here. No snowboard necessary on that one. And then this one, we're doing the snowballs and the trees. And like I said, had I realized there were dies, this card might have looked completely different, but I don't know. I kind of like not having dies all the time. It certainly saves a lot of time. Okay, so now we're here. We need to bring in a ton of alcohol markers, and I'll show you just a few highlights and a few little tricks. We want to get some texture in the bunny and in the little seal. He's a seal, not a walrus, right? No tusks, so he's this little seal. So we want to get a little bit of texture there. Also, I want to do a little bit of splattering because I think that'll look nice. So I'm just going to come in with my balmy blue and my aqua painter. And I just want to just add just a little bit of splatters around for some snow. It's just a little, it's just a touch. And also I've stamped a couple snowflakes. And it's got three little snowflakes, but I don't like that they are always together. So I'm actually just going to trim them apart. Don't be scared. And sometimes there's a lot of excess rubber and I'll just trim that off too because I don't want it to ink and catch an edge. But I really like when my snowflakes, I can put them where I want them and I don't always want three together. And in this particular case, the snowflakes don't have dies, so it's safe to cut them apart. That is better. So now I can kind of pick and choose which ones I want to stamp and where. And I'm just gonna do one here, one down here, one, I'm gonna do one little one up here, and I'll do this little one up here. There we go, that's gonna be covered up, so that's okay. I'm gonna be adding a few other little snowflake embellishments too afterwards. Okay, let's do a little bit of the blend technique. Remember how we did scribbling? So scribbling is when you want to add a little bit of texture. So we're not gonna color everything in. Okay, so we're starting with light smoky slate and scribbling and leaving quite a bit of white in there. Then we take the darker smoky slate. We're gonna do a little bit of accents right here. Dark crumb cake and dot in some of these and do a little bit more scribbling with the dark crumb cake. Now we're doing dark crumb cake instead of the dark gray because then he becomes too dark and you can't really see him. Okay, blend back in with a little bit of the light smoky slate. Blend that in. There we go. A few more little speckles and a few more little scribbles down the bottom. See how that just gives a little bit of texture as opposed to just being solidly colored in? We're gonna do the same thing with the bunny. We're gonna do light crumb cake, and I like using the bullet tip for my scribbles. We're doing light crumb cake all over the bunny. It's a lot faster than trying to color and be perfect too. A little bit on the ears. Coming back in with the dark crumb cake scribbles and dots, scribbles. A little bit around the ears. So what we're trying to get is just a little bit more texture. Okay, dots around his face. Not too dark because we don't want his face to disappear. Come in again with your light. I'm nowhere near an expert in alcohol markers like Copics and all of that. I just know that I don't like it completely covered in. And sometimes if you just do a little dotting and a little scribbling, you get a lot more texture and it looks really, really cute. So the only thing else that I did that's gonna make this is take your regular basic gray marker, and now we need to ground everything. Otherwise he's just floating. See the difference between here and here? So we need a little bit of water for this guy. This one doesn't need anything. This could use a little snow line right there. And this one needs a hill because he's coming down the hill. So we're gonna give him a little hill right here. And then we're gonna define it with our light balmy blue marker because that's gonna make everything look like snow. So we're gonna do just a little bit of the line here. And then this is gonna be green for the tree. And then so we need just a little bit of the balmy blue right around the edges, and we can soften that with our clear marker. A little bit on these snowballs right here. And we need a little bit on his ice, right? Because obviously he's sitting on ice. And a little bit on this hill line right here. The rest of it you guys know how to color in, but I wanted to give you the highlights on the coloring. This is your clear color lifter. And use the bullet tip and go in little circles, scoot it over. You can hear it, you know it's working. And blend in anything that looks too harsh. Just kind of take away a little bit, like this line right here is a little harsh. I'm just going in nice long strokes, and when it dries, it'll be softer. Okay, so if you do all of that, the snow will look a little less harsh. Now we're gonna fast forward here. So I've added my blue strip, my 9-inch strip to the bottom, and I need to erase where I drew. Even though it may be covered up with my circles, I don't wanna take a chance on it. So we're gonna do some erasing. So I used the light cherry cobbler. I used just jade, the light and dark on those for my blends. And I did a little black on his skis here. That looks pretty good. Okay, and now we're ready to put these back on. So, good amount of adhesive all the way around. And add our circles back on top. Okay, all right, so I've got that glued together, and then I realized this is the one I pre-colored and I hadn't stamped my snowflakes in yet. So of course I grabbed my snowflakes and I got a gray one, is what it is. It's gonna stay that way. Now the other thing that looks really nice is this cute little snow spray, wind looking thing stamp that comes in that set. And it really makes it. It's absolutely what it needs to put a little something extra on the outside. I want to do a little masking here to make sure. So I just want to make sure, I could have done this before, but I wanted to make sure that this isn't gonna show. There we go. Isn't that cute? Just those little guys. You know, and we still have this frost white ink. And you know, I like to use it with my stylus to kind of put it where I want it. So a little bit in the cap. And I'm just gonna add a few little things here and there. Just to add a few little snowflakes. And I'm gonna do the smaller size stylus next to it. Just to add a little bit of something. And then we have those adhesive backed snowflakes. They have a tint to them. Let me show you. One has a pink tint, And one has a blue-green tint. I'm going to use the blue-green ones on this one. Let me see if I can cover up my gray snowflake. Oh my gosh. Linda, Linda, Linda. Oh, that makes it worse. That makes it worse. I'll have to do something about that. I might have to put a greeting over that top part. So just a few of these little adhesive-backed snowflakes are kind of cute here and there, just because they add a little extra shimmer. All right, I need to add my little banner down here. I was going to add a banner up here to cover up my gray snowflake, but it's going to cover up the top of the tree. So I'm going to leave it, and I'm going to add a rhinestone to the gray. You know, maybe they won't notice. Look, there. Nobody will notice. And just to balance it, we'll do one more little rhinestone over here just to kind of say, oh, I meant to do rhinestones this whole time. Dimensionals on the back. This one says, life's better when we're having fun together. So be a sweet family card. Okay, now I'm finally done. This is going to get glued to the back here. See how the blends soak through the alcohol markers? That's normal. But I didn't want to see that on the back, so we had to make that extra panel. Oops, I'm out. I'm out of glue. Out of tape. I really like that. This really lasts a long time. There's so much more on it than the snail that we had before. I really like it. Ah, we're done. Inside, I just did this little raccoon who's coming in on a sled and on top of here. Just sending warmth your way. So there it is. Oh, the envelope. Oh my gosh, I almost forgot the envelope. Okay. All right, to make your own envelope, 12 by 12 paper, or if you have legal size copy paper, that works great also, or designer paper, but cut it down to 9.5 by 12. If you score at 4.25 right here, I mean, technically this little envelope, the business envelope, is 4 1/8, but I have mailed these and they were fine. So it's just easier than dealing with all the eighths. So you're going to, in portrait, vertical position, score at 4.25 and score at 8.5. Turn it to landscape, score at 1 inch, and score at 10.5. So this is gonna be your bottom flap and this will be your top flap. Now all we have to do is do a little bit of cutting because, so this is gonna be our flap that holds everything together. It doesn't have to be that big. I mean, you could just have a 1/2 inch here, which is fine. But sometimes having more glue here and make it more sturdy, especially if you're using copy paper, works well. And so what we have to do is take off some of the bulk. This is gonna be our little flap. So we're gonna cut this part off, cut this down here. And I probably did it upside down, but it won't really matter. You'll see. Okay, this will be the bottom flap. So you're gonna come in about 1/2 inch. You can measure it, of course, or come in like 1/4 inch and make your little flaps, okay? See, so there's your bottom. That'll come up and glue right there. Then your top. This is going to be your pretty flap, so we need to cut this part off and make this not so bulky. Cut this part off right here. And here. And same thing, come in 1/2 inch here, or you can make it rounded or whatever you want to do. There. So this is the basic bones. Good of amount of adhesive. And like I said, I might take that down another 1/2 inch, but it does give it some stability. Here, bottom flap, here, okay? And then your card will fit in. Easier and less expensive to just go buy the business envelopes, but if you really want to be custom and have ink on the on it, so this will come here, washi tape, or if you're mailing it, use the tape to tape it up. And that's how I do my custom slimline, they call them now, envelopes. Oh, thanks for sticking it out with me. This was a long one. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.